So Jan, today we are going to talk about some of your books. Perhaps the first one is the earliest one is Kingdoms of the Savannah, and then the Tio Kingdom, Children of Wood. I don't know which one is.
Yes.
And then maybe going to Living with Africa, which is. 1994, it's actually the year you retired.
Yes.
Isn't it? Okay. So we can go to that. Of course, there's Pass in the Rainforest, right. 1990, which was a big big seminal work. And looking at those books, I was wondering, you know, what kind of look you an idea you have when you look back at those books. Remembering when you wrote them, why you wrote them this way, the state of African history at that time.
Well, you see, Kingdoms of the Savannah is quite interesting because it's the first book I wrote in Madison.
Really?
And I wrote it specifically under pressure of Philip Curtin.
Really? Because I saw it's a series of lectures, right?
It was a set of three lectures, and we had to do the lectures to convince people at the university, not just in our departments, but people at the university, that Africa was interesting and that African history, there really was a history there.
Ah, I see.
So, Curtin convinced me to do these three lectures, and I was then at the Institute of the Humanities half-time, and the lectures were to be at what was then a completely new building of the social sciences
in the
biggest hall they had there. Well, not the biggest, but a big one. So they were in the evening. So, you know, I started with the first lecture, and which is the beginning of this. And then, well, people did not go away. And some people, there were some people half full. So then for the second lecture, the hall was almost full, which was much more interesting. And then for the third lecture, they were overflowing.
Really?
So from week to week, this was talked about. And the third lecture was, I think, 10 days later. So it was a big thing. And lots of people came. And that convinced them, convinced the faculty and the general public that... that Africa was interesting. You know, it was followed then with lectures elsewhere in the city of Madison, especially in churches here and there. So we managed to convince enough faculty members all over the place. And this book did it to a certain extent.
Right, because the lectures were in 1961, which is really early.
Yeah, they were quite early.
Well, what year did you arrive in Madison?
1960.
Oh my God, yeah, so it was right 1 year after that. But you published it 1966, so you probably wrote it...
Well,
took a couple years.
Right, these were three lectures, and they were, as you saw, done in a fairly fast way. So they needed to be backed up by more research and, you know, expand them. And I wasn't going to do this, but Philip Curtin insisted, I remember him insisting, no, you've got to do this. And, you know, remember University Press, the editor of the press was a friend of his. And he absolutely wanted to get more African books in the press. Up to then, he had only one, but he had one, which was Phage's History of the Gold Coast.
Oh, right.
Phage had been here as a visiting lecturer a few years before. So, you know, I was called, so I had to do it. I did it. It was finished in about a year earlier than the publication, and then, you know, the press worked at it. Meanwhile, in Kinshasa, they wanted a translation of this.
In French?
In French, and they got a translation published in Kinshasa before the original was published here.
I see.
It's not nearly as nice, but you know.
Yeah, but it's important for historians. Now,
you see, if you read the preface, you can see that they have big misgivings. And I talk of this book as something like a Swiss cheese with more holes.
I know, because I was reading the, exactly, I was reading the preface and you really said, oh, you know, I was unsure I should do it actually because there's so many, so many holes and gaps. I came to wonder if I should have kept that promise at all. And any synthesis is out of the question.
Okay.
And you also say that data kept coming in from the field.
Yes.
So you were in touch, you were in contact with...
Well, I was still in contact, in fairly close contact with people in Rwanda, about the Rwandan material. And I was in contact with Kinshasa, especially the University of Slovenia, and of course with Brussels.
Right.
In other words, I could get more information.
Right.
But that was actually what I could manage, you know.
Well, when, what do you think now? Do you think it actually is... It's
no, what I see now is that it's a book that's completely out, you know, it's completely, it has done its job.
Yeah, oh.
And its job was to stimulate research.
Right, but it's, I don't think it's that, it's very outdated.
No,
still
but...
Still a good introduction to...
But you see, you have to realize that there are 12 PhDs that have been done on
because
topics
of this book.
From this book. So for practically every chapter, you have to look at more recent work and to get a, you know, more nuanced view than this. It is, of course, what I very much what I would call a youth work. It's full of enthusiasm and it doesn't bother too much with the handicap.
Did you... this is the only one you did on the Kingdoms of the Savannah. I might be wrong, but I thought I remembered a shorter one that you did, or maybe it's the one in French. That
it's the one, it's a translation in French.
In French, which is shorter. It's not
well,
as long, is it?
You see, it's printed differently. It's printed on cheap paper.
Ah, okay.
It is printed very closely. The maps or the drawings are much smaller and so on and so forth. But then, of course, it was... priced, I think, at about one-tenth of the, this book was priced. And it's the one book that spread throughout much of at least Lower Congo. It had such success in Lower Congo that they founded a church called the Church of the Kingdoms of the Savannah. This lasted for a few years.
Really?
And it also was smuggled into Angola. It was forbidden reading
in Angola.
In Angola, because of the Congo chapters in there, and the comments on the Portuguese in Angola, so it enjoyed quite a bit of success.
Right. And it was your first book in English. Your first book that you wrote in Madison.
It was the first book I wrote in Madison, and I think it was the first book in English. Yes.
Yeah.
I think so. Right. But no, yes, not sure.
Yes. And so after that...
After that comes this
it's
one.
It's a Tio Kingdom, right?
The Tio Kingdom.
Yeah, right.
And the reason for writing that is
That's completely different. And it's a completely different book. It's really not so much a synthesis as an incredibly deeply researched, a lot of details, a lot of... you feel like there's no gap in the Tio Kingdom.
No. No, you see, what happened was I got this money to do research. And I thought that I was going to do research amongst the Tio, that's north of Brazzaville, because it was a famous old kingdom.
Right.
I thought there would be traditions of this and that and the other, and I would be able to write something like Cuba history, but at the other end, with the Kasai in between. You know,
that's why you chose the Tio, because... you had already done your dissertation on the Cuba.
Yes, oh yes.
So you didn't want to go back to the Cuba, you wanted a different kind of kingdom.
Well, you see, I wanted to do what was possible.
Yeah.
What was possible in 1963 was Congo-Brazzaville, yes, the Congo-Kinshasa, no, because the rebellions were practically on the way, you know, they were ongoing. So And I did manage, we managed to get there just after the coup.
Right, when exactly, Yulu, because it's
Yulu was overthrown.
Right.
And there were no new regulations yet.
Okay.
So they let me in.
And also in the two kingdom, in the Teke plateaus, you probably were fine. I mean, I don't...
Well, you see, they were also a healthy place, by the way. I didn't know that, but it's a very healthy place.
Yeah, I've been there,
In any case, all right, I arrive, I start, and I find out after about a week and a half, two things. First, that the language was quite interesting, but very different from Kikongo.
Hmm.
Very, very different. It, you know, there are comments on the different